You're about to listen to the unadulterated word of God from Reverend David Kakati.
When we were in the world, we were dancing for the devil. When we came into God, we have hidden all the dancing that we used to
do.
As for God, we are telling him he doesn't deserve to be praised.
Yes.
The one who created us, he doesn't deserve to be praised. So we gave the dances to the devil. But the Bible says in the book of Psalms that give the Lord the dance.
That's what the Bible says.
Bible says, where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Okay, where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty.
So,
don't allow anything to sit on your joy. Don't allow any psychological thing to sit on your joy.
No.
Celebrate God. I said celebrate God. I realized that people were seeing Jama for House of Oak.
Yeah.
They were seeing Jama. Yesterday,
and I saw that people were seeing Jama for House of Oak.
House of Oak, which is just on the earth.
Yeah.
They are not ashamed to see Jama for House of Oak.
And so now
they are not ashamed to see Jama for Kotoko.
Yes. Yes.
One day, years ago, I was walking somewhere. Then I saw a bus passing. And they were playing drum. Hey, Jobodo. Hey, Jobodo. They are praising political parties. We have something better than political parties. I said we have something better than political parties. We have something better than House of Oath. We have something better than Kotoko. Can you give the Lord a mighty clap of it? Can you give the Lord a mighty clap of it? And give him a shout in the house. Say in the name of Jesus Christ, invisible powers. Say invisible powers. Manipulating my mind. So that I cannot praise the Lord. You are a liar. You are a liar. Jesus Christ. Invisible powers. Sitting on my jaw. In the Lord. You are a liar. Break now and aspire. Break now and aspire. In the name of Jesus Christ. Please sit down. Sit down. The Bible says the joy of the Lord is our strength. The joy, that's what the Bible says in the book of Nehemiah. It said the joy of the Lord is your strength. Praise God.
Amen.
Without the joy of God, you are weak. Without the joy of God, you are weak. You may have enough money in your pocket. You may have enough money in your bank account. Without the joy of the Lord, you are weak. The enemy can bring you down. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But when you are full of the joy of God, you are strengthened by God. When you are full of the joy of God. You see, people want to be joyful in anything except in God. You see, they want to be joyful in everything except in God. People want to be joyful in everything except in God.
Yes.
That is why when Satan fire the arrow, it will get them. Because they are not strong. Please, come and sit here for me. That's why when Satan fire the arrows, it will get them. Because they are weak. Yes. But when you are full of joy in God,
you celebrate God,
you praise Him, you are grateful to Him.
Now, when you saw me, Nyamia,
He will inject you with divine strength. The things that will kill others cannot kill you.
The things that will destroy others cannot destroy you. Am I talking to somebody at all? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The joy of the Lord is our strength.
So you must be joyful in God.
Don't
allow anybody to sit on your joy in God. Am I talking to somebody? So when you come to church, don't look at the one on your left. Don't look at the one on your right. Look at the Lord and give him praise. Because you know that the Lord has done something for you. Say, the Lord has done something for me. So I will praise him. Amen.
Amen.
If you don't love God, we will love God. If you don't appreciate God, we appreciate God. We can remember what he has done for us. We can remember. Say, I remember.
That's a Mekai.
It's presidential candidates who need endorsement from me. They need Kokromoti. They need you to endorse them. And MPs, they need endorsement. But the God that you and I serve, doesn't need the approval of men. Praise God. There is no argument. There's no argument about who he is. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I encourage you to hold on to your God very well. Lift your hands to him. Say, Lord Jesus, save my soul. Change my life. Open my eyes. Stir my faith. Give me understanding. Let the wonders happen in my life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
We don't want to be valuable in everything of the world and be valueless in the things that matter to God. When it comes to God, do you matter? When it comes to God, do you matter? When it comes to the sight of God, do you carry weight in his sight? Do you speak for him? Do you carry value in his sight? Or you are only valuable to your family? And you only defend your football club? And you only defend your political party? So you are valuable to them. But when it comes to the Almighty, are you valuable to the Almighty? Is your life precious in the sight of the Almighty? Can the Almighty say that he wants to protect you and defend you because you are precious in his sight? What have you done for him? What have you invested in him? How much have you invested in him? And what have you lost for him? Praise God. So count your life and measure your life from the time that you were little up to now. How much of your life have you invested in him? How much of your life have you invested in him? How much of your years and of your time and of your resources have you invested in him, that he can look at you and say that you are valuable unto him? Count your 30 years that you have been alive on earth. Count your 40 years that you have been alive on earth. Count your 50 years that you have been alive on earth. How much of your life have you invested in him? Praise God.
Amen.
Footballers promote their football club. Political parties defend their parties. People of God, we talk about God. That is what makes us people of God. Am I talking to somebody at all?
No,
that is what makes us people of God. We stand for him. We speak for him. We advertise him.
We announce him, we broadcast him, we publicize him. That is what makes us people of God. Praise God. If football supporters will not keep quiet on the stadium and they'll be hailing their football, I will not keep quiet about my God. I said, I will not keep quiet about my God.
Yes,
football, that will not take them anywhere. Politics that will not take them anywhere. But the God that will give them eternal destination, eternal habitation, he is the one that you and I we have. We will not be quiet about our God. We will not be quiet about our God. Say, I will not be quiet about my God. Say, I will not be quiet about my God. Say, I will speak. My God is not a dead God. Say, my God is not a dead God. My God is a living God. He is the Almighty. That is the God we have. We have something better. Praise God. I'm speaking by inspiration. I'm not speaking from my notes. Praise God. Yes. When I take the microphone and the Holy Ghost begins to move, yes. I'm not speaking from my notes. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Say, Holy Ghost, I need your fire upon my life. Say, Holy Ghost, I need your fire upon my life. Look, I look at how political parties defend their parties on radio. On radio and television.
Our radio, so.
Then I said, Christians, we have a lot to learn from them.
Then Christopher, you will be if you want to.
They should have been learning from us by looking at how committed we are to the Almighty. But we have thrown our good thing away. And they value what they have. So every night on UTV, political parties will be there to defend their parties. Because they value that earthly thing that will not last. They value it. We have something eternal. We have something beyond the grave. We have something more valuable. Say right now, that spell and enchantment. Say that spell. Again, say that spell tying my mouth, tying my mouth from speaking for the Lord, from announcing the Lord. Say, Lord, arise and break that spell. Say, I declare that spell is broken. Say, that spell is broken in the name of Jesus. Say, Holy Ghost, make me an evangelist. Say it again. Say, Holy Ghost, make me an evangelist for yourself in the name of Jesus Christ. Job chapter 10, verse 16. Let's do some few things. He said, you are hunting me like a fierce lion. You are hunting me like a fierce lion. Verse 17. And you renew your witnesses against me. Verse 17. You renew your witnesses against me. The changes and the war are against me. There are some changes when they come, they favor you. There are some changes that are against you. We are going to pray against changes that come and they fight you. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
We are also going to pray against battles that are against you. He said, you are hunting me like a fierce lion. Verse
16.
And you renew your witnesses against me. Before they take somebody to a juju for the juju to spoil the person, they send accusation to the juju man against the person.
When
the juju man activate the evil spirit and send the evil spirit against the person,
and they
come against the person,
and
they don't get evidence or attestation or testimony against the person, they cannot touch the
person.
If they have spiritual witnesses and physical witnesses against the person, say in the name of Jesus Christ, every agent that is hunting me, say in the name of Jesus Christ, any spirit that is hunting me like a liar, you are a liar, I paralyze you now, I paralyze you now in the name of Jesus Christ. Say right now, every power hunting my children, every power hunting my glory, every power hunting my destiny, every power hunting my future, you are a liar, expire, I paralyze you now in the name of Jesus Christ. Say right now. Yes, the sound is sweet, the sound is getting better. Say in the name of Jesus Christ, evil witnesses, negative witnesses against me in the spiritual, in the physical, I cancel it now by the blood of Jesus Christ.
So
right now, evil witnesses against my finances, evil witnesses against my employment, evil witnesses against my shining, your time is up, I cancel it now by the blood of Jesus Christ. Say right now, any place where they are witnessing against me, it is nullified, it is nullified, it is nullified in the name of Jesus. Say right now, I speak to the changes and I speak to the battles that are against me. I speak to the changes and I speak to the battles that are against me. Expire in the name of Jesus Christ. Say right now every agreement of evil forces, every agreement of physical forces against my welfare, break and expire, break and expire in the name of Jesus. Please sit down. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
He said, though we are walking in the flesh, we are not warring in the flesh. So we are warring. There is a war. Praise God. There is a war. You can go to church all your life and nothing will change. But something must change. There must be an evidence in your life, over your life, that you have met God. That you have met God. There must be a change. And that is when the Holy Ghost comes upon you and is at work in your life. You need the Holy Ghost. I've been saying that there are some of us, our Holy Ghost is sleeping like zombie.
We must
melt him. Amen.
Amen.
Through the word of God. Through prayer. Through fasting. We must melt him. I don't want to be a Motro Mojo Christian.
Christian
is that the person is not hot and it's not cold. You don't know where he's standing. When they are against God, he's also against God.
So what could you?
When you get to a place where they are for God, then you also say he's for God. He is neither hot, neither is he cold. I want to be on fire for him.
The
fire is available.
I said
the fire is available. Once you start hiding your Christianity, it means you are fireless.
So
once you start hiding your Christianity.
You see,
I respect the politicians. They don't hide their political I respect the politicians. They don't hide their
politicians.
I respect them for that.
Boom.
See positive things somewhere, copy it. Copy it. Am I talking to somebody at all? I respect them. They don't hide their political position. Say, I will not hide it again. Say, I will not hide it again. Something must happen in your life. Something must happen in your life.
Say, baby,
in Acts chapter 1, verse 8. Acts chapter 1, verse 8. He said, you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you. Then after that, you start talking about me.
If you want to, if you have to say, what can you mean, sir?
Soul winning is a warfare. It's a battle.
Say,
It's not a matter of going to see somebody and just tell him about Jesus Christ. Then he will get up and follow you.
Yes, no, so it doesn't happen like that.
Soul winning means you are going to somebody that Satan is in charge of him. That is why he's not in God. Satan is in charge of him. And you are going to collect the person from Satan
and
bring him to Christ. It is not better, sir.
Enough.
It is a warfare. Soul winning is a warfare. Amen. When I went to Amanfrom, when the bishop took me to Amanfrom, the one who was there was a master follow-up pastor. He does a lot of follow-up.
But still,
people were not going coming to church.
And so nani pa ma sorry.
Because after you have done evangelism and after you have done follow up, you have to break the demons that are manipulating the people. Before they can come to church. If you don't break the demons, you will use drizzling to stop them from coming to church. You will use rainfall to stop them from coming to church. You will use traffic to stop them from coming to church. You will use discouragement to stop them from coming to church. So after you have done evangelism and follow up, before you do evangelism and follow up, you have to be fasting and praying. Breaking powers. When the powers of the wicked is broken from the people, they will come to church. So winning souls is a warfare, it's battle. So when I got to Amanfrom, in addition to the follow up and evangelism, I did a lot of prayers. All these things I learned it from the bishop. So in Luke chapter 11, so after I did a lot of praise, the soul started coming. So in Luke chapter 11 verse 21, when a strong man who is armed is keeping his palace, all his goods are in peace.
Ọ̀pàbrania ọwọ́ akọ̀dẹ́ sọ ṣẹ́ na him fie anani fie.
All his goods are in peace.
Na ẹja padi nyina ẹwọ asunwe mu.
But when a stronger than he shall come upon him.
Na ni ọwọ́ ahọ́n dín sin no bá ni so a.
And overcome him.
No di ni so a.
You take from him all his armor and weapons that he trusted him.
Ọbẹ̀ jí na akọ̀dẹ́ ẹna ni biribi a ọwọ́ jídí ẹwọ́ mu no.
Then you take his properties. So anybody who is not in Christ is a property of the devil.
Anybody.
Doesn't matter whether he's dressed in suit and tie. Once he's not in Christ,
Satan
is his master.
Doesn't
matter how beautiful the English he speaks, how innocent he looks. Anybody who is not in Christ is under the mastership of Satan. He may be a professor. He may be a medical
doctor.
He may be a lawyer. He may be a teacher. Anybody who is not in Christ is under the mastership of Satan. Satan is the strong man. So you, the child of God, use prayer and fasting plus the word of God to break the power of the strong man. Then you can collect the people from his
hands.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. And it's a continuous battle. Continuous battle. It is an unending battle. So a prayerless evangelist cannot get souls.
Nti osempekenia ombompai no.
Yes.
Otumintwe akra.
He is entertaining the people.
Enu ane oma o meniji.
He doesn't have what it takes to break the power of the enemy from the people. Bring them to God. He doesn't have
me. Awo ma brabo so.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Yes. That's why you can follow people up, but they will not come. You need to do warfare. Break something.
Se obedi amanfo echi na wakosra sra omo no. E se o sam bompae na honhom edi e tie o meche e mo mba soro no. Sa honhom ni firi ho.
You are in church today because you have overcome the powers that prevent people from coming to church. Today you have overcome it.
Ene tumi e manipa mba soro no. Ene wedi ni so nti na wa soro.
They will not stop. Next week they will come again. Because when Satan came to Jesus, the Bible said he left Jesus for a season.
Christian channel also jano ewom britie.
So Wednesday they know we are supposed to come to church. They will come again to stop you. Friday they know we are supposed to come to church. They will come again to stop you.
Obeba no abe si ukwan
sina be. So I said it is what a continuous battle.
Okun aye toko soko.
Your spiritual level must rise.
That
when they come in the morning, you shall overcome them. When they come in the afternoon, you shall overcome them. When they come in the night, you shall overcome them. Continuous prayer and fasting is the word of God. Put you above them. Any day, any time, anywhere, you shall defeat them. So it is not just physical; it is a supernatural, spiritual. Praise God. Am I talking?
You will be, Kasa.
Yes. That's why before we go and do crusade, we are praying, we are fasting. It is not crusade time that we are going to pray and fast. Fasting must be your lifestyle. Not crusade time.
Emre, before we are going to do
special prayers and fasting.
No.
What being who did that?
Ya bompai dada, ansana ya ko.
So it is through prayer and fasting and the word of God, faith in the word of God, that you being yourself.
Then I'm by ball any nyamia sama be suani akom chire so. And I say what
bubuna so on your mim. Uber corner uber bas safe and intact. Number when him bray.
You are no.
Praise God. This is my message. This is my message. Is it clear? Is the message clear?
Yes.
Is it clear? Yes. Raise your level. I'm going to pray. Don't like this kind of Christianity that I struggle to serve. I don't like it. Tell God, I don't like this kind of Christianity. I don't like this kind of Christianity. I want the kind of spirituality that I am always on top in the spirit. I'm always on top. That's the kind of spirituality.
Yes.
Holy Ghost, come upon me again. Come upon me again.
That
even when you are sick, you will be the one encouraging people. Even when you are sick and you are sick bed, and people are coming to sympathize with you, you will be the one encouraging
people.
You are full of the life of God. You are full of the life of
God.
It is the Holy Ghost. He said, you shall receive power. Acts chapter 1 verse 8. You shall receive power when the Holy Ghost come upon you. Then from there, you will not be silent again. You will become my witnesses. What is the power? You can't tell me you are powerful in God when you are not a witness for Him. No. It is lack of power that makes people not to be a witness. When you receive that power, you start talking about Him. You start testifying about Him. The power is there. It's there. But it is sleeping. The power is there. But it is sleeping. You are going to pray the Holy Ghost, let that power resurrect. Let that power resurrect. There are some of you here. Years ago, you used to be on fire for God. There are some of you here. Used to be on fire for God.
Now.
This
year,
that fire is not. I can select some of you here right now. Now the fire is not there. But it can come back. We are pouring petrol on the fire.
Yes.
I said we are pouring petrol on the fire. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Oh, yes, good.
Amen. So be near G football. Now me and me won Yamino. It shouldn't happen. Yes, it's an error that must be corrected. Bibia tosin, bibia yira.
Something is missing.
Obi in the football club. Ano di ni party sticker. Eja tali ni kan hun. Ano di wahwa no hun.
Bring that fire back to us.
Praise the Lord. Yeah, but it's not within. I've been for a describe who I'm say, ah, sir, buy you an one or ye jano or ye jano. Your person ain't dinner with you, my man. So, ya, and so, and ye, and ye, ye, but describe you are, ye, de ja, never describe.
Describe it, they'll describe you by fire.
Sir, be one no, or 90 and a ja won it is so no. Ah, you throw say ye, and some cano no, or no one sem na ye cano.
Amen.
Is it that? It has happened before.
It will happen.
Declaring.